Hey guys, welcome to Simon Says Cycling. This is Simon from Simon Says Cycling. And today we're going to talk about how to go faster with less power. And like, how is that possible, right? How can you go faster with less power? Well, you can. And actually, this relates really specifically to flat riding. But here we live in Florida, it's very, very flat. And many times, what I've experienced is that we can actually save a lot of power when we ride in a more aerodynamic way. So how do you go faster with less power? Well, you know, for years and years, we struggled to push that threshold power up by 10, 20, 30 watts sometimes, 40 watts, depending if we've been racing and training at a high level for a very, very long time. Whereas if you just make a few changes to your position, you can potentially save 20, 30, 40 watts. What that means is, say your buddy rides at 300 watts and you ride at also 300 watts. Now, if you can adapt your position in certain ways, you can now ride side by side, and instead of putting out the 300 watts that you used to do, now you're putting out 270, 280 watts. And what are the differences you've made? Well, there's a few key things that you can look at to really go faster with less power. And number one is your position on the bike. Now, this is key, right? So, you know, the best position really is the position where you're holding on the brakes, where your forearms are parallel to the ground, holding comfortably on the brakes, making sure you still have a firm grip on the brakes, that you can still pull your brakes if you need to. This in the wind tunnel is really shown to be, for most people, the most aerodynamic. Right there, you're saving 10, 15 watts over sitting up higher or sitting in the drops. So sitting on the brakes, holding on the brakes, arms parallel to the ground. Now, the next thing you want to look at is how tight is your cycling jersey? This, in fact, is probably the biggest boost in speed is having a really skin tight cycling kit. Now, some of you, maybe you carry a bit extra pounds, you don't want to show that extra belly. Well, guess what? You can see that either way. So get over that. Get yourself a really nice tight skin jersey. Right there, you've saved another 10, 15 watts. And then you can look at your helmet. Some of the helmets these days are very, very aerodynamic. Some are not. Some have very big holes and lots of grids. It's quite easy to see which helmets are more aerodynamic. So just making those three changes, the position, skin-tight jersey, and a more aero-type road helmet could potentially, in my experience and also in the testing we've done in the wind tunnel, save you at least 20 to 30 watts compared to if you're wearing a loose jersey, you're sitting up higher, and you have a helmet that's very not aerodynamic. So right there, you've gained speed with a lot less power. And in cycling, remember, it's all about the head and the legs, right? So when you use your head, you can often outsmart your buddies. So that's my tip for the day. Go out there, have fun. Simon Says, make it a great day.